Let's check on European markets first. European markets are down as investors brace for the latest meeting minutes of the U.S. Federal Reserve, as well as a first quarter earnings report of AI chip leader Nvidia. In the UK, investors are reacting to data showing Britain's inflation in April fell to 2.3%. While that's the lowest in nearly 3 years, it was less than the expected 2.1%. Over in the U.S., futures have ticked lower, with retailer Target reporting weak quarterly results and second quarter outlook below expectations. Nvidia, which is set to report after the bell, will test the strength of Wall Street's recent bullish run.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of some auto stocks, including Mercedes-Benz, BMW, and Stellantis. That's as concerns grow after a Chinese government-affiliated research body said China should temporarily raise import tariffs on gasoline-powered cars. All stocks are down at least 1% in midday trading. Also in focus, shares of Marks & Spencer after it reported a 58% increase in its annual profit, surpassing market expectations. Shares of the British retailer surged 7%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Citigroup after it was fined by UK regulators for control failings in its trading operations. Citigroup shares are down 0.3%.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mostly lower ahead of the key reports from the U.S. The Nikkei 225 slumped 0.8% as Japan reported a bigger-than-expected trade deficit. That's in light of a weak yen affecting imports. Here at home, the local bourse fell for a second day, with the main index barely managing to stay in the 6,600 level.
I think today's trading has really been dictated by technical factors. We are bumping into the moving averages, which has proven to be a pretty strong resistance. But I remain bullish on our market. I think there's plenty of reasons for investors to remain bullish. The biggest of them all is that Philippine growth and corporate earnings have just been absolutely amazing. And I think that presents a very compelling investment opportunity for a lot of people.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Shares of Nvidia suppliers rose ahead of the AI firm's first quarter earnings report. Meanwhile, Hong Kong listed shares of XPeng surged 13% in Tuesday trade. That's after the Chinese EV maker reported revenue growth and gave an upbeat outlook for second quarter deliveries.
The Philippines, U.S., and Japan kick off talks on the Luzon Economic Corridor. Representatives from the three countries met on the sidelines of the Indo-Pacific Business Forum in Manila. The U.S. State Department says the Trilateral Steering Committee discussed priority sectors for engagement and reviewed potential projects and areas of interest. The corridor, which pushes for the connectivity of Subic Bay, Clark, Manila, and Batangas, will be developed under the Partnership for Global Infrastructure and Investment Indo-Pacific Economic Framework.
The Philippine Trade Secretary signs the implementing rules and regulations for two acts aimed at boosting the economy. Secretary Alfredo Pascual signed on Wednesday the IRRs for the Internet Transactions Act and the Tatak Pinoy Act. The ITA establishes regulatory policies for commercial, electronic, or online transactions. Meanwhile, the TPA provides the industrial sector with a development framework based on innovation and technology,
which will enable us to keep up with the rapid changes in technology and make full use of this disruptive situation in the technological space, because it will give us the means to produce the products and services that are competitive and that will generate value for our economy.